Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to our Mass of the Holy Spirit. For those that don't know me, my name is Elliot Gualtieri. I am the Dean of Mission and Ministry here at Fairfield Prep. And again, it's a great honor and a privilege for me to welcome all of you to our Mass of the Holy Spirit, including those joining us on the live stream. A special welcome to our friends from Belen Jesuit who join us from Miami. And in a special way, we also welcome Father Willie Garcia Tunon, who is the president of Belen Jesuit and will be our principal celebrant today. Also a special welcome to our own Fathers Perry and Consman and members of the Fairfield Jesuit community, including the Jesuit Superior, the rector of the Jesuit community, Father John Mulrini. A bit of housekeeping. If you need a restroom during Mass, hopefully you don't, but if you do, you can get there just around the choir and up those stairs into the doors there, as well as these doors here where the procession is coming out right now, but you can get to the bathrooms there on the first floor if you need those during Mass. I encourage you to please sing with our choir and respond to the prayers where appropriate in the worship aids this morning. The Mass of the Holy Spirit is a tradition among Jesuit academic institutions dating to 1548, in which the community gathers to thank God for the gifts of creation and salvation, and to seek the guidance and wisdom of the Holy Spirit in the coming year. So we pray to the Holy Spirit this morning. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you will renew the face of the earth. So let us make that our prayer this morning as we gather as a Jesuit community here in prayer. Thank you. And I think our choir is ready. Thank you, Mr. Horseman.
All of this morning's music is found in your worship aid. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
So I'd like to, first of all, introduce myself. As they mentioned at the beginning, my name is Father Willie Garcia Tuñón. I'm the president of Belen Jesuit Preparatory School. And I want to thank all of you for being so generous in welcoming us here this morning for this extraordinary event of having this football game together. So on behalf of the varsity football team, the coaches, the parents, administration, we want to thank you all for hosting us and having us here. We feel very delighted to be here. For us, coming from Miami, it's extraordinary to be here celebrating this outdoor mass without the heat and the humidity. So I'm expecting none of my kids to pass out today like normally happens down in Miami, so we're happy about that. And enjoy this moment of fraternity, these brother schools coming together to play football on the football field. So as we begin this Mass of the Holy Spirit to kick off your academic year, I invite you all, my brothers and sisters, to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Taught the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that in the same spirit we may truly be wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, this is the fasting that I wish, releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking every yoke, sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go for you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, Here I am. If you remove from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in the darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. Then the Lord will guide you always and give you plenty even on the parched land. He will renew your strength, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring whose water never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Congregation, please stand for the singing of the Alleluia. Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me,
but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The last time I gave a homily in front of the entire school was back on May 20th. As a reminder, and for those who weren't there, in that homily, I laid out a challenge: not to wallow in anger, not to hate, and not to seek vengeance. The key to fulfilling that challenge, to living out our call to this dreadful thing called love, is to bask in the love that surrounds us, the love that Christ has for us, as we heard in today's gospel, the love that surrounds us from our family and friends who have gone before us, and the love that we have for one another. Some of us have met that challenge really well. Others of us, well, we're having a harder time with it. And that's kind of okay. The challenge we've been given to love is tough. We're human, and sometimes we're going to fail. It's why we have the sacrament of reconciliation. But that challenge never goes away. God is constantly calling us back to love, reminding us of it, in some ways making it more elaborate and even more demanding. It's what we heard in the prophet Isaiah today. What God expects is sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own. Removing from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech. All of that is just a way to take love one another as I have loved you and give it teeth, make it real. And yeah, it's tough. But we are called to do difficult things. If you want to hear about that, talk to the guys who do Habitat for Humanity. Building a house for those who need one is hard, labor-intensive work. But even more difficult, as I think many of us have come to learn over the past few months, even more difficult is getting our interior house in order. The work of self-reflection and conversion. Fortunately, God never abandons us or expects us to do that work alone. He gave us Christ, he gives us each other, and the link between those two, he gives us the Holy Spirit, which we celebrate and ask for even more at this Mass today. A little earlier in the same gospel passage from John, Jesus says, "But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and remind you of what I have said to you." The Holy Spirit helps, he teaches, he reminds. In that way, I tend to think of the Holy Spirit as being like a teacher, not like a teacher of the sort we have in a classroom usually, but someone who teaches really physical and technical skills. Two examples. The first is something like a strength coach. If you've never been in the weight room and you go start lifting, you might see some results. But the chances are also high that you'll have bad form, right? That you risk injuring yourself. And maybe you won't progress as fast as you otherwise could. A strength coach teaches you the skills you need, reminds you when you need it, and helps you become the athlete, the kind of person you're trying to become. The second example is of a music teacher, Mr. Horseman. If you're trying to learn an instrument, it's possible to teach yourself, but it's really hard. A good music teacher will help you learn how to think about music, how to feel rhythm, how to move your hands, quite literally, and the right progression of songs to practice so that you quickly become more and more skilled, so that you become the musician, the kind of person you're trying to become. That same kind of work as a strength coach or a music teacher, that's the kind of work that the Holy Spirit does. It teaches us the skills we need, points us in the right direction, reminds us when we need it, and helps us become the kind of person we want to become. Good people. Holy people. But that only happens when we're open to accepting help. In the same way that we have to seek out and actually listen to a strength coach or a music teacher, we have to seek out and actually want to listen to the Holy Spirit. And that is the work of prayer, of spirituality. The challenge to love one another as Christ loved us is held out to us today the same way it was for a month ago and the way it will be for the rest of our lives. My brothers and sisters, we cannot do that alone. Not well, anyway. We need the Holy Spirit to help us, to teach us how. If I could encourage you to do one thing this year, it would be to open yourself to the Holy Spirit by learning how to pray. Go on a retreat or two. Read a spiritual book. For guys who go to Fairfield Prep, talk to Mrs. McCormick or Mr. Smith or Mr. Perry or me or really anybody else at the school about prayer and learning to pray. Guys from Belen, you should do the same with your campus ministers, teachers, Jesuits, and everybody else you have supporting you in Miami. I promise you all, by listening to the Holy Spirit and then doing what it says, you will become better men. We will become better schools. And our world will be transformed by the love of God into the kingdom of heaven. Ad maiorem Dei Gloriam.
As a community of faith, let us together now present our needs and intentions to the Lord.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our church that, led by the Spirit, she may inspire the world to greater love God and neighbor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember on Sunday's anniversary of 9/11 all those who were lost, as well as the tremendous faith and service of our first responders and caregivers during our nation's time of sorrow and grief. Most of all, we remember those who died in New York, Washington, D.C., and Pennsylvania. We pray in a special way for three Fairfield Prep alumni who died: Michael Jacobs, class of 64, Gary Lasko, class of 69, and Seth Morris, class of 83. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those serving in our military, we pray in gratitude for their service, and we pray for their safety and well-being. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in gratitude for our brothers and friends from Belen Jesuit Preparatory School. May our friendship, camaraderie, and support of one another inspire all those in our communities to continue to seek accompaniment and meaningful connection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Fairfield Prep adult community. May God's Spirit inspire and strengthen us in our renewed desire to become women and men open to growth, religious, loving, committed to justice, intellectually accomplished, and striving for wellness of mind and body. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our seniors who will be an example to us, as they begin their special year of service to those who are excluded and are on the margins, help them with their college searches as they have helped others. May all prep students grow generous hearts through their service to others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our juniors and sophomores, may they realize more deeply their talents, the gifts of the Spirit, and how these may be used to build God's kingdom here at Prep, and as they take their places in the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our freshmen and our transfer students, may they feel welcome to Prep and know by experience that every upperclassman stands ready to help them through their years at Prep and beyond. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our friends and family members who are sick or suffering in any way and for those that care for them, especially Dieran Mirabel, Fairfield Prep class of 2017, and Paul Wysocki, brother-in-law of Fairfield Prep faculty member Jamie Whiteman. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died recently who are connected to our Fairfield Prep and Belen Jesuit communities, especially Jimmy McGrath, Fairfield Prep class of 2023, Roger Ratchford, Fairfield Prep class of 1951, and longtime faculty member Patricia Pollard, mother of Julie Pollard, and Lucy Fernandez, student of Our Lady of Lourdes Academy and Belen Jesuit. May they and all others find eternal rest and peace in God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those needs and tensions that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, good and gracious God, listen to these prayers that we present to you at the celebration of this Holy Eucharist. We ask all this through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, and in the name of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Please join in singing our offertory hymn, Holy Spirit, Come Now.
Come now.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all God's holy church.
Amen. Sanctify, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made here, and cleanse our hearts by the light of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's holy peace. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
If we can just have everyone please sit. So as we let our Eucharistic ministers get to their places and our ushers find their places, the way communion will run, since there are so many of us, we will have four Eucharistic ministers up front, four in the middle by the tree, and four in the back. These front two sections, you will come like we normally do at Mass, come through the middle, receive, and return on the ends, okay? In the back row of the very back section, you will turn around and receive behind you. The front row of the back section will receive with Father Perry, Father Consman, Nick, or Tony. Okay, and then we will flow from there. There are ushers, so please just follow the ushers and hopefully it will flow as designed. As we normally do, all of you are welcome to come up and receive in whatever way you would like. If you are Catholic and ready to receive, you'll do it in the normal way, hand over hand, amen, and go to sit. If you would like to just receive a blessing for whatever reason, you are more than welcome to do so. We just ask that you cross your arms in front of you so that the Eucharistic minister knows to give you a blessing. Okay. Thank you all.
Singing our communion hymn, Many and One.
Yeah. Let us pray. May the outpouring of the Holy Spirit cleanse our hearts, O Lord, and make them fruitful by the inner sprinkling of his dew, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Before we mission our seniors at Fairfield Prep, I just wanted to echo Father Konsman's great message of love. And in love, we live and suffer and experience grace. And so as we begin this missioning of our seniors, I would also ask us to remember as two communities, as the Fairfield Prep community and Belen Jesuit, to remember two great men for others, our brothers gone to God, Jimmy McGrath, class of 23, and Anthony Perotti, class of 23, who pray with us now to the Lord our God. I now ask the senior class of Fairfield Prep to stand. As president of Fairfield Prep, it is my honor and privilege to now mission you to go out into our community and serve those in need at your service placements this year. I ask Father Perry, Fairfield Prep's chaplain, to offer first some words of blessing.
We bless you, O God, and we praise your name. In your merciful providence, you sent your Son into the world to free us from the bondage of sin by his own blood and to enrich us with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Before he returned, triumphant over death, to you, Father, he sent his apostles, the bearers of his love and power, to proclaim the gospel of life to all peoples. We ask you to bless the class of 2023 as they begin their service projects. May they be bearers of your love and care to all they meet.
Lord, look kindly on your servants. We send them forth from Fairfield Prep as messengers of salvation, justice, and peace. Guide their steps with your mighty arm, and with the power of your grace, strengthen them in spirit, so that they will not falter or grow weary. Make their words the echo of Christ's voice, so that those who hear them may be drawn to the gospel. Bless their hands, Lord, so they may do your will and be your touch of compassion and love.
Fill the hearts of these young men with the Holy Spirit, so that becoming all things to all people, they may lead many to you, the Father of all, to sing your praises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, man. You can be seated. Well, it's my great pleasure to offer greetings, certainly to our Fairfield Prep community, and a warm bienvenidos to our Belen Jesuit community all the way from Miami, coaches and parents. We are so honored to share this experience with you and our Mass of the Holy Spirit. Welcome, welcome. We offer a very special welcome and thanks to Father Willie Garcia Tunyong, Belen's president and a proud 87 graduate of Belen, for celebrating this beautiful liturgy with us and supporting this wonderful event for our two schools. Muchas gracias, Padre.
You're welcome. De nada.
To our dear brother, Tommy De Casada, past principal of Prep, we welcome you back to your second home here in Fairfield. With abrazos grande, amigo. Welcome, welcome. Great to see you. To our Fairfield Jesuit community, Fathers Perry and Konsman, Father Savard, Father Mulraney and Perry, thank you so much, and O'Brien, for being great members of our team, for supporting us in prayer and all things at Prep. We are so grateful for you. Thank you to our Jesuits. And certainly a heartfelt thanks to our campus ministry team, musicians, servers, lectors, operations, advancements, sound, all of the many details that made this a beautiful Mass today. We say thank you. And we thank the Holy Spirit for this beautiful cathedral we have outside in this autumn splendor. I am so deeply moved today and consoled to witness this gathering of two remarkable Jesuit school communities, celebrating one of the oldest traditions in Jesuit education to gather and bless the year with the Mass of the Holy Spirit. Today, the Spirit animates our uniquely Jesuit way of proceeding here at Prep, at Belen in Miami, across our nation and across our globe, with thousands of Jesuit students, men and women, millions of Jesuit alumni around the world,
we seek to create a more just and compassionate society that walks toward a hope-filled future. And as we sit in this glorious place today in the quad, let us never forget the granted gifts to us that God has given us, remembering that everything that we have and everything that we are is a gift of the Spirit to be used by us and put into work in a world which desperately needs these sons of Belen and these sons of Fairfield Prep. We look forward to a fantastic and spirited contest this evening between two great Jesuit football teams. We ask the Spirit to keep our young men safe and to guide our coaches in wisdom and give us joyful hearts in the knowledge that no matter the victor this evening, we walk off Rafferty Field as sons of Ignatius, brothers and champions of Belen and Fairfield Prep in the Jesuit tradition. May the Holy Spirit propel us forward this year and urge us to listen as Ignatius taught with head and with heart to our deepest desires and put all our gifts to work in service to those most in need and on the margins. And may we do this always and in all ways, ad maiorem Dei gloriam, for the greater glory of God. Go Wolverines and hail Fairfield Prep. Thank you. This is a Catholic mass. We have brief Catholic announcements. First, to our Belen families and our players, we are so thrilled you're here. I believe you're going to remain here for a moment before some campus tours. It was not a ploy to put you in the sun, so we want to hydrate you too. There are bottles of water around and restrooms for after mass. Our boys will be dismissed by class, of course. It is our tradition as well at the Mass of the Holy Spirit for the prep president to declare a holiday at the conclusion of our mass. Apologies, Father Willie, if I put any ideas in the heads of your young men, but it's a prep tradition. Okay, there we go. So I am pleased to announce to the prep community that in thanksgiving for this wonderful academic year and in honor of the freshman treat held for the first time retreat in October, the president's holiday will be Monday, October 10th for a nice long, long weekend. Enjoy it, boys. Peace.
Before the final blessing, once again, thank you to all of you for having us here. We're looking forward to this for a long time, and we're excited to be here. And there's a tradition in our school. Our school is dedicated, and many of you may not know this, Belen, which was founded in Cuba back in 1854. Belen is the Spanish word for Bethlehem. That's where the name comes from. And there's a long story about that. You can read it on the internet if you want to, but the school, since its very founding, was dedicated to Our Lady of Belen, who's our patroness. So we have a tradition in our school that we conclude every single Mass with the singing of the Salve, which we're not going to do the Salve, but we are going to pray to the Blessed Mother to conclude the Mass. And I often get asked by the kids, why is it that we have such a devotion to Mary and why so often pray to the Blessed Mother? And at the end of the day, there's no more powerful intercessor. There's no one's prayer is more powerful than the prayer of the Blessed Mother. The first miracle Jesus ever performed was a miracle that was Mary who asked. She interceded. And to just explain a little bit how much Jesus loved Mary and the reason why he always listens to her, there's a very popular Cuban kid in Miami whose name is Pepito. You don't know who Pepito is, but Pepito's a very famous Cuban kid in Miami, and the story goes that Pepito one day, when he was little, he went up to his mother and asked his mother, he says, Mom, I want a bicycle. Can you give me a bicycle? Pepito's mother looked at him and said, Pepito, I'm sorry, we don't have enough money. We can't afford a bicycle. So Pepito had the idea of praying for it, so he went to his room and he decided that he was going to write Jesus a letter. So he sat down at his desk and he took out a sheet of paper and a pen and he began to write, and he says, Dear Jesus, I have been a very good boy. Please send me a bicycle. And Pepito looked at him and he goes, this guy Jesus, I know because my grandmother tells me all the time is very smart and he knows this is not true. So he ripped up the paper and he got to thinking. He took out another sheet of paper and he wrote, Dear Jesus, I've been a pretty good boy. Can you please send me a bicycle? And he realized, no, this Jesus is not going to buy that. So he started thinking again, and he had an idea. So he ran over to his grandmother's room, and his grandmother had this little statue of Mary in his room. So he took the statue of Mary, and he hid it under his bed, and he took out a sheet of paper, and he wrote, "Dear Jesus, if you ever want to see your mother again, you better send me a bicycle." He understood the love that Jesus has for his mother. Would do anything if Mary asked. So I'm going to invite you to stand together with your brothers here from Belen Jesuit, and we offer a prayer to our Blessed Mother as we say, "Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Almighty God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. It is our tradition here to sing our alma mater for Fairfield Prep before our recessional hymn. The words are found on the back of your program. Standing for our recessional hymn, Go Out, Go Out.